Hi, welcome to the Retirement Railroad January update for December 2020. I'm Steve, and let's take a look at everything we got done. As you see here at the Great Lakes Industrial Park, we finished primarily most of that during November, and been adding little details here and there. And so then we moved down to the harbor seam. Right, and you can see a little Burlington Plymouth switcher there underneath the crane. It's pulling a couple of southern gondolas. Down there with scrap metal, getting ready to load them in that barge in the river. As we move across the river, you see that there's a gondola down below the meatpacking plant, and that gondola is loaded out with hides and such, headed to the tanning factories. And you'll notice that we got some landscaping done over there at the meatpacking plant. A few trees and some grass done. Let's go ahead and take a look at it from another angle, and I'll share with you another improvement to that scene. All right, now look at the meatpacking plant. We see that the lot out front is complete. You see some hanging beef in there. That's been there. And of course, we do have smoke. I don't have it on at the moment, but you may hear something. The cows seem a little restless, don't they? That's a soundboard from CMR Products. I love it. Sounds adjustable. And I have it and another soundboard hooked up to my automated power control system. Alexa, pigs on.
Okay.
All right, we have pigs too. Yeah, I got two soundboards, both hooked into smart sockets, controlled by Alexa. And you'll see there, I finally found a fountain to simulate Buckingham Fountain on the Chicago downtown lakeshore. Got the girder pieces in around the entrance to Union Station there and the meatpacking plant as well. All right, well, let's swing around and see where most of the effort's been for the month. All right, so here we are. Down looking at the Cicero Engine Servicing Center. We've added all these tracks and turnouts. Matter of fact, there's this turnout, and a turnout back there. This siding goes to Downers Grove to the Heinz Lumberyard. We have two tracks for engines. There's currently five parked in there. In the back, there's another siding for the oil servicing. You can see the front end of the blue tanker back there. And there's also a Santa Fe switcher on the siding that leads around to the Pepperidge Farm Bakery. Right. Back there, where you see can't hardly see it, but there is a turnout back here that we added so that the bi-level commuter train can sit back there. All right. And in the foreground here, you see the Heinz Lumberyard. I still need to add lumber to it. And in the back of the lumber yard, you have gravel, coal, and sand which Heinz also dealt with, and you have the loading dock, where flat cars and hoppers can be unloaded, along with box cars. Now behind the lumber yard is the Pepperidge Farm Bakery. This whole area here, I call the Fairview area, Fairview Avenue, Downers Grove, because that's where the Pepperidge Farm Bakery and the Heinz Lumber Yard were back in the 1960s. And in this area over here will be the Fairview Street Burlington Station. Now, there's also going to be a backdrop here and kind of a forehead drop right here and across, all right, with puff trees on it to add to the scenic break between the Downers Grove area and the Cicero area, which is actually in actuality about 10 miles apart, maybe 15 even. There will also be a backdrop there where those very old front building fronts are, and there will be some industrial picture fronts that will go along the backdrop there once completed. You can also see where we've started our plastering or hydrocal here. That will work up into this area in here. And there will be trees here and back behind the backdrop. We did some weathering of our switches and added the rock fascia. So we've got this area to scenic in January. Along with all the rest of Cicero and Downers Grove. After that, come February or March, we'll start working on the farm scene back behind the desk. With backdrops, etc. there, which will then lead us to putting in the 110-foot turntable here with engine sheds, roundhouse, at least three stalls back in this area. There will also be a diesel fueling station here with a siding back under the cabinet desk area, back to the lava flow, so to speak, for cattle loading. Alright, so that kind of gives you the overview where we're at and where we're going here at the Retirement Railroad. Alright, and after all this is done, we still have this area back around over here, where Union Station and the flats will be. Okay? So, what do you say? Let's go run some trains. Thanks.